It's crunch time here at the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour in Barcelona. Just 24 remain in the hunt for the €850,000 first prize. Team pro Eugene Kachalov is eyeing that rare beast, the Triple Crown.
I mean, obviously, like, EPT is now the one thing that's eluded me. I have a lot of pressure on me.
For Belgian pro Matthias de Mulder, whatever the outcome, EPT Barcelona will be his biggest live cash.
It's just one way to the final table, and let's hope I find the right directions.
Standing in their way is a host of formidable local players headed by current chip leader Tomeo Gamilla.
I'm sure a Spanish player win the EPT.
And he wants to be that first ever Spanish champion.
To be the number one, for sure, it's nice.
It's time for the final 24 to become the final eight. More than 45 million tourists visit Spain every year to enjoy the food, sun, and culture. But it's the chance to win €850,000 and take down the coveted EPT title that drew 811 of the best to the Casino Barcelona for one of the premier events in the poker calendar. Day three saw the bubble burst, followed by a flurry of exits, including Brazilian Andre Akari, colorful Italian Mario Adinolfi, and local lady Leo Marguez. And now we're at the business end. It's day four, and the last 24 will play down to the final eight. Team pros Eugene Kachalov and Matthias de Mulder headline our feature table, along with six other EPT hopefuls. Well, Kachalov's form this year has been sublime. He won his first bracelet in Vegas this summer and is now well-placed to become the fifth Triple Crown winner.
Started off with a bang at the PCA during the World Series. I was able to win a bracelet. That makes me feel amazing, you know, to have a shot at the Triple Crown.
Belgium's Matty de Mulder was on the brink of elimination yesterday, but he turned a stack of 60K into more than a million and comes into today as one of the chip leaders.
My first goal this year was make the money, and then it was get past the position I finished last year. I managed to do that, just going for it.
One player who needs a bit of luck is the last lady standing, Isabel Baltazar. She's coming into the day as the short stack. This restaurateur needs to dish up something sweet to make the final table. As always in Barcelona, the field of homegrown talent is immense. Leading the charge is Tomeo Gamilla, who took the chip lead at the end of day three. He has a monster stack and home field advantage.
And I like when Spanish people are behind the line and say, "Hoy!" It's nice. It's nice for the players, for sure.
Both Eugene Kachalov and Matty de Mulder join Tomeo Gamilla at our feature table, with the Spaniard off to a flyer, busting Hungary's Benjamin Juhasz to put him over the 3 million chip mark. So day four action is underway at our seven-handed feature table, and two members of Team Pro are getting to know each other.
Are you from here?
No, Belgium.
You're from Belgium? Oh, okay.
Eugene comes to us from the Ukraine via New York City.
Those countries are really, let's say, westernizing now. It used to be like Poland, Ukraine, really gray, old communist. Yeah, yeah. But now it's getting better, actually.
In the capitals, it is.
Ethics, yeah, yeah. It's really traditional. But it has something to it. I like it.
Well, Joe, the players at our featured table are on or above average in chips, with the exception of Ruman Nanev.
Pretty interesting. Nanev was crippled yesterday by Eugene Kachalov, was down to 60K, managed to work it back up to over 360,000.
The blinds are 12,000 and 24,000 with a 3,000 ante. Action will be on Dragan Kostic, one of the locals, one of the Spanish players remaining in this tournament, looking to win it on home soil. He folds under the gun. Matty de Mulder with King 8. Or muck. Javier Contreras gives up the 9-7. Martin Suzor from Hungary will also pass. So Tomeo Gamilla on the button has 7-3 off.
And he is reaching for chips. A lot of players will raise any two cards on the button, so I guess the 7 high offsuit 3 gapper technically counts as any two, but barely.
He raises to 48,000.
Keep in mind, you don't always have to raise your button. Just fold sometimes, Brosif.
48. I thought it was in the same level.
So Kachalov facing a min raise in the big blind with King Jack off suit, and he defends.
Especially when Eugene, the final table machine Kachalov, is in the big blind.
The flop. Ace high.
Gamilla somehow flopped huge with his hand, ended up double gutted here.
And he continues. Makes it 50,000. Eugene makes a quick call.
And Eugene's right to think that King High would be the best hand here a lot of the time, because it is.
Four of diamonds on the turn, pairs the board. Eugene checks.
He's picked up no additional draws or outs.
Gamilla fires a second barrel, 103,000.
Nice double barrel from Gamilla with a very disguised hand. It looks like he can barely contain his excitement.
Well, Eugene's passed, so Gamilla will add even more chips to that ridiculously huge stack.
And speaking of excitement, this is the second most excited I've ever seen Eugene. We don't talk about the first.
Eugene will be on the button in this next hand. Kostic and De Mulder in the blinds. Javier Contreras under the gun. Check four off. I'll pass that. Martin Suzor gets out of the way. 6-7 offsuit for Gamilla. Doesn't want to play. 10-6 for Nanev.
Nanev is down to only 12 big blinds and it's been folded to him, so he may be tempted to shove.
I'm all in.
He does.
Not a huge fan of shoving with this hand. He's still got three players to get through.
And one of them's got ace-king.
Snap call. Actually, although Eugene doesn't have a ton of chips either, so he must be thinking about whether or not he wants to reshove or just call. Last thing he wants is to take this flop four ways.
He does reshove. So Kostic in the small blind will pass. De Mulder in the big blind will also fold. Nanev is at risk. It's all about timing this game. At least he's got two life cards.
Ruman is drawing live.
But he will need to hit, or he will be eliminated in 21st place. So Jack-Jack 3 flop.
No draws whatsoever on the flop, looking for just a 6 or a 10 ball.
The turn brings no help, still has 6 outs. A 14% chance of survival. An 8 on the river, Ruman Nanev, crippled by Kachalov yesterday and eliminated by him today. He'll collect 20,000 euros for that 21st place finish.
Kachalov finishes the job and he's finally above average. And seriously, Eugene, try not to celebrate so much. Show some class.
Eugene's a very good player. I mean, I played with him during the Poker Stars big game and he impressed me, I gotta say. He's a very solid player. I mean, if he needs, to make a big fold, he'll do it. If he needs to make a big bluff, he'll do it as well. So he's very tough to play against. If he has chips, watch out, because he's a dangerous one. So, for me, I cheer for him, so let's hope he wins it.
Let's head to one of our outer tables, where we find Isabel Baltazar all in. She's in great shape here, though. Jacks against sevens. No help for Sar Wolf on the flop.
Isabel wants the dealer to keep him big.
The turn card is a 9, so now the board's paired. The last lady standing has to sweat a 7 on the river. She's home and dry.
Oh. And it looks like Wilf has just been awarded the booby prize.
Isabel Baltazar more than doubling up to 578,000. Well, there's a big pot building on our other outer table. Juan Corneo opened with a raise to 52,000. He's been 3-bet by Marcos Fernandez.
We got some Spain-on-Spain action here. Lots at stake. Loser has to go to bed without tapas.
Well, there's a 4-bet from Corneo. An additional 152,000. And Fernandez announces call. He will play the flop in position. There's already 624,000 in the middle. The flop is King 4-7 with 2 diamonds. Corneo had the pre-flop betting lead, and it looks like he's going to continue. He bets 250,000.
I do remember some Spanish from school, but unfortunately I'm useless unless someone's asking where the biblioteca is.
Fernandez asking how much Corneo has behind. And he shoves.
All in. Does anyone have an English-Spanish dictionary?
And Corneo has snap-called. Ace-king for Corneo. Jacks for Fernandez.
Fernandez tried the old stop-and-go, but it doesn't work when your opponent's got top-top. Oh, superior in Espanol.
He'll need to see a jack on the river to eliminate Corneo.
Que lastima.
His pair of kings hold. And Corneo gets the double up. He's now well above average with the stack close to 2 million.
If I'm not mistaken, James, I believe Conejo is now in the top five in chips.
Indeed, he's fourth in the tournament overall. There are three Spanish players in the top five, the other two being Raúl Mestre and Tomeo Gamilla, who's consolidated that chip lead. He's now closing in on the 4 million chip mark. That's a 166 big blind stack.
Half of the top 10 are from Spain, James. We've never had a Spanish EPT champion. It's looking pretty bueno right now.
19 players remain. Martin Suzor, ace eight of diamonds under the gun here. And he will raise to 50,000. Gumilla mucks the jack four. Eugene Kachalov has passed. Dragan Kostic gives up his button. Matty de Mulder has king 10 suited in the small blind.
I don't see Matty folding this hand, but Suzor did raise under the gun, so I'd expect this to garner some kind of respect.
No respect shown. It's a 3-bet to 127,000.
Interesting. I'm assuming these two must have some kind of history. I guess de Mulder isn't really that far off in his read if he thinks Suzor isn't all that strong.
Contreras has given up the big blind. It's back on the Hungarian. And Suzor is going to 4-bet his ace-8. Makes it a quarter of a million straight.
These internet kids are loco in the cabeza.
De Mulder makes a quick fold, and Suzor adds 166,000 chips to his stack.
I believe that's what the internet kids call clicking it back.
Frustrating for Matty De Mulder as he drops below a million and below the tournament average. Welcome back to the European Poker Tour from Barcelona. Summer's a relaxing time in the Catalan capital. But inside the casino, the poker carnage has started early on day four. Eight players have already had their EPT dreams shattered. We're down to two tables of eight, with seven locals still in contention. This could be the event where a Spaniard finally wins an EPT. Chip leader and fan favorite Tomeo Gamilla is among the most recognizable players in the country. He's a poker coach and he's featured on numerous Spanish TV poker shows.
I play all tournaments in Spain. I have, I think, 8 or 10 final tables is TV table. It's nice. It's nice TV table.
And he knows a thing or two about his fellow countrymen.
Dragan is from Mallorca. I play with him in house games. And Pibe is a very good friend of Maceiras. Raúl Mestre is a person who I learn a lot with Raúl. I think he's the best player in Spain.
But he wants the title for himself.
To be the number one, for sure, it's nice.
Well, Gamilla has been crushing at our feature table. But right now we've got action on our outer table. Isabel Baltazar looking for a double up with nines. Once again, she's tangling with Saar Wilf, but this time she's not a 4-to-1 favorite. This time it's a flip.
She did double up through Saar just a little while ago. Isabel's getting ready to leave. I love this move. Definitely a plus EV play.
The flop is low.
Wilf has whiffed, and that's Isabel's partner Thierry looking on.
She has to sweat. Aces and kings. The turn is a 10.
Saar seems pretty disinterested.
Once again, she doubles up. And once again, she flashes that joker.
And Isabel takes it down with her pair of nines.
And that takes her up to an ample 945,000. So back to our feature table, where the blinds are up to 15 and 30,000 with a 4,000 ante. And we have two new players at the table, including Martin Schleich, who'll fold under the gun. Martin Suzor gets out of the way. Chip leader Tomeo Gumilla has Jack 10 of hearts.
Jack 10 suited can be a very juicy hand.
He raises to 66,000. There's the other new player, Evgeny Setsev. He's folded. Kachalov has mucked. Dragan Kostic with 6-5 offsuit has the button.
Hands like this can be very tempting in position, but you have to tread lightly if you're looking to take it out and mix it up with the chip leader.
Well, Kostic has made the call. Matty De Mulder in the small blind has ace deuce off.
Ace deuce is not super strong in this spot. Someone sent in Belgian hostess Gail Garcia Diaz to distract Matthias' twin brother. Don't like where this is heading. He doesn't really have the stack to get cute with ace deuce, although he is quite cute in a Justin Bieber sort of way.
He has 3-bet to 187,000.
Matthias' stack has taken some severe hits of late. This is a risky play.
Contreras has folded the big blind. Gumilla doesn't look like he's going anywhere.
I actually have no issue with Gumilla calling here. He's in position to the 3-better, and Jack 10 suited plays very well after the flop.
I raise.
Gumilla isn't calling. He is 4-betting.
This is a surprising re-raise for sure. Maybe he senses De Mulder's desperation.
505,000. How awesome would it be if Kostic shoved?
I assume 6-5 off is getting out of the way.
He folds, and Matty De Mulder folds. And Gumilla shows the Jack 10.
I'm not sure that show will really tilt Matthias all that much, though he is left with around 20 big blinds after that. Look at him just chomping away on that gum. Are you sure it's not spelled Gumilla?
Well, Tomeo has now moved above the 4 million chip mark, putting some distance between himself and Saar Wulff and Raul Mestre. Isabel Baltazar is now among the top 8 players. But if you look at the bottom half of the leaderboard, Matty De Mulder is among the guys who could really do with a double up. Well, Finland's Mika Antonen is hoping to get that double up. He's got queens. Isabel Baltazar has jacks.
Can someone please tell Mika his hat's on crooked? Tis a bit of a cooler.
Isabel just earned those chips. Looks like she's going to be sliding them across to the fin.
4-1 says she is.
The flop. There's a jack in the door, and Antonen is disgusted.
What was that? Talk to the hand. See you later.
Mika needs to spike a queen on the river to survive.
Baltazar looking to dodge a 2-outer. And that jack on the flop has knocked Mika's hat even further off to the side.
The river card is a 5. Some more chips for Isabel Baltazar. And the elimination of Mika Antonen in 16th place. Baltazar now sitting on a stack of over 1.6 million. And while that was kicking off, Evgeny Setsev was eliminated from our feature table by Martin Schleich.
Just too much action going on here. Only 14 players left.
So we're 7-handed. Eugene Kachalov is going to raise under the gun to 65,000. He's got jacks. Matty De Mulder's got chip issues. And 9-10 of spades. They'll go in the muck. Javier Contreras has ace-king.
And he has fewer than 23 big blinds.
He shoves.
Pretty standard shove.
Schleich folds the button. The blinds will both get out the way. Back on Eugene.
Eugene's never folding.
He makes the call, and that will put Contreras at risk.
So we've got one of the remaining Spaniards racing for his tournament life.
Kachalov's pair is the marginal statistical favorite. Ooh, that was a tad lecturesque.
Such a bad feeling when you miss that flop.
Ten of hearts.
De Mulder hoping to see a backdoor draw get there on the turn. Well, it is a heart.
Many more outs.
Any ace, any king, any heart saves Javier Contreras.
Eugene knows he's in this hand, right?
The river is a blank. Contreras hits the rail.
And we say adios to one more Spaniard.
That was a crazy bluff the other day, man. You tilted me so badly. Nice hand, Jin. I didn't mean to really root against you. I was just saying with 10 of hearts for some sweat.
Oh, that's okay. I do that same thing.
I do the same thing.
Eugene Kachalov is always a contender.
Uh, 2011 has been an incredible year for me. I started off with a bang at the PCA. The 100,000 buy-in super high roller, and I happened to win it, which was amazing, and also beating Daniel was amazing, heads up. In the summertime, during the World Series, of course, I was looking forward to it a lot, and I was able to win a bracelet, which I was really, really happy about, and then I had a shot to win another second bracelet, but it didn't work out, but overall, I'm pretty happy with it. I've had a couple of, multitude of deep finishes. Like, I had a really deep finish in Madrid in the EPT, and now I'm having another deep finish here, so I'm very happy about it. Maybe Spain is my lucky country. It makes me feel amazing, to have a shot at the Triple Crown. I mean, obviously, like, EPT is now the one thing that's eluded me, since I have everything else, so it would be incredible. I think it would be the best of the three. It would conclude my three. It would be the tournament that kind of made my career, really, like, defined my career, which would be amazing.
Eugene is aiming for that Triple Crown. At the moment, he just has the Double Crown, which is obviously a huge embarrassment.
Only four players have achieved the Triple Crown. Two of them are British, just saying. Action has been folded here to Eugene Kachalov. He doesn't want to play. Dragan Kostic on the button. Or raise.
Clever, no? A bit of a string raise there.
Goes to the min raise. 60,000 to play.
Seems like an honest mistake.
I'm sleeping. This is hour for my sleep.
These Spaniards and their siestas. It's 11 a.m. Matthias doesn't have a ton of chips left. Seems like a weird spot to just call, and folding's out of the question.
I'm all in.
He shoves from the small blind. To Kostic's amusement.
And boy, that Christoph is always so excited.
Thank you.
Oh, Schleich's got ace queen in the big blind.
Ace queen suited. Even though we know he's racing, I think this is an absolute call for Schleich. With Kostic's floundering on the button, De Mulder could easily be shipping a super wide range. I'd say this might even be a call with ace jack.
He lets it go.
Wow, can't say I like the fold, but he did avoid a coin flip.
Kostic folds the 7-5.
Big fold?
A borderline hand, obviously.
Not really.
Good fold.
Ace queen suited, not quite borderline in that spot.
I mean, it's always good.
And without seeing a flop, De Mulder has added more than 100,000 to his short stack. If you want to play in an EPT event, go to PokerStars.com, where there are qualifiers every day. Spain at the Casino Barcelona for the PokerStars.com EPT. 13 players remain in the fight for a seat at the final table. Six players right now at our feature table.
And there's Martin Schleich.
Big blind. Action on chip leader Tomeo Gamilla, mucking the 7-4. Ace-9 for Eugene Kachalov.
Shorthanded, this hand's value goes way up.
He raises to 65,000. Gets Dragan Kostic to fold. Matty De Mulder has ace-8 suited on the button.
We know Matthias is dominated, but he is short, and what I just said for ace-9 goes for ace-8 as well. He knows shorthanded Eugene could be raising worse. He also knows he could be raising better.
Those orange chips are worth 25,000 each. Yellows are 5,000. The red chips are 1,000.
65? Yeah.
Doesn't look like Matthias is folding, and I know he's not just calling in this spot.
He will re-raise. It's a 3-bet to 133,000. Schleich gives up the small blind. Martin Suzor folds the big blind. Decision is with Eugene.
Now, it's easy to just shout at the television screen right now. One, because you can see the whole cards, and two, because you're drunk. But just because Eugene happens to have Matty dominated doesn't mean this is a call mathematically. By not shoving, I think Matty's done a really good job of making this three bet look pretty strong.
And that's why Eugene gives up the better hand.
Matthias, you keep on calling him Martin.
I don't know why.
Yesterday Matthias. You did it the entire time correct.
And yeah, I'm sorry.
All of a sudden I changed to Martin.
I don't know why.
I mean, the name is okay, but it's not mine. Were you drinking last night?
No.
No, you were. You're lying.
Let's find out some more about Martin. I mean, Matty.
Well, Matty has had three cashes on the European Poker Tour, including this one. His best result to date was a €20,000 score in San Remo. He's a former kids' TV presenter, and he loves the EPT TV shows.
My favorite EPT moment must be Noah Buchan winning EPT Copenhagen. And I was 19 at the time, and I was sitting there, wow, if I could just be part of that just one time. Yeah, that definitely inspired me the most.
That's so weird because my favorite EPT moment was the time Matthias De Mulder talked about his favorite moment being Noah Boken. What? I haven't been around that long.
Time to get inside the head of Eugene Kachalov. We're going to sweat with Eugene and we're going to play this hand from his perspective. We won't see his opponent's hold cards. We know that Eugene is raising an early position with sixes.
Dragan Kostic looks totally disinterested in this hand, which immediately makes my spidey sense tingle.
He's going to re-raise. The three bet is 160,000. Gets folds from De Mulder and Schleich. And Suzor.
Eugene could probably four bet with this pair pre-flop, but against an older guy like Kostic, no offense, they're usually bluffing far less frequently.
He decides to call and go set mining.
Sixes could be good on their own, James.
Well, actually, that's not a bad flop for sixes. Just one over card. Eugene checks.
Checking to the raiser. He doesn't want to get raised, but he's probably not folding on this flop to just one bet and one over card out there.
389,000 in the pot. And the continuation bet from Kostic is 230,000.
So much of Dragon's range missed here that he'd have to bet anyways. This is a pretty ob spot to just peel one off and reevaluate on the turn.
Eugene counting out the call, and he will make that call.
Obviously, Eugene would just love to see a six and lock this hand up.
The turn is a king, not a good card for Eugene. That's firmly in Kostic's range.
That king is all over Kostic's range, like you at an open bar.
Ha! Guilty as charged. Check, check on the turn. And ten of spades on the river.
Another not-so-great card for Eugene. Gotta wonder if Kostic has it in the check, a king on the turn.
Well, Eugene checks the river, and Kostic is counting out chips.
Eugene still has plenty of showdown value.
300,000 is the bet.
This is a weird bet. It looks huge, but actually is for less than half the pot. Think if Kostic is capable of checking ace-king on the turn or value-betting a hand like queens or jacks here, this is a fold. It's either a weak bluff attempt or a super-thin value bet. If you don't think Kostic is capable of regularly making thin value bets, this is probably a call. Personally, I don't see Kostic all that capable of thin value against Eugene.
Eugene folds, and Kostic was bluffing.
Nah, it's so obvious once you know what the cards are.
But I don't blame Eugene for showing him some respect there. Well, there's a player at risk on our outer table. A preflop shove of 230,000 from Marcos Fernandez, called in two spots pre by Raul Mestre and by Sarl Wilf. Action went check, check on the flop. And on the turn, Wilf will lead out for 200,000, which gets a fold from Mestre. And Fernandez does not like what he sees because he is drawing dead. Wilf will seal the deal with a pair of aces. And Fernandez will be sent to the rail in 13th place. He'll collect 29,000 euros. Well, that pot catapults Sarl Wilf to the top of the leaderboard. He's playing more than 5 million chips. That's a 170 big blind stack. If we look at the bottom half of the leaderboard, we'll see the players at immediate risk are Jose Miguel Esteban and Martin Suzor. Tomeo Gamela still chip leader at our feature table. He's in the small blind on this hand. Dragan Kostic is first to speak. He's folded. Matty De Mulder doesn't want to play the queen nine. Martin Schleich gets out of the way. Martin Suzor folding the button. Ace 10 in the small for Gamela.
This is an absolute no-brainer raise, small to big.
He's announced a raise. And he makes the raise to 65,000. King Jack in the big for Eugene.
Gamela's raising range is likely so wide, small to big, we might see a 3-bet, although King Jack is too strong of a hand to 3-bet fold and too weak to 3-bet call a 4-bet.
And that's why Eugene elects just to call. He sees a flop and he hits his jack, but Gamela hits his ace.
Eugene does have position. Do not like Gamela's flop check at all. He's missing a ton of value and giving a free card.
And that free card gives Kachalov 2 pair. He takes the lead, and now Gamela's betting.
Such a weird small bet, like tiny.
It's a min bet.
And Gamela is annihilating that gum.
Kachalov decides to raise.
I love Eugene's raise here. There are all kinds of draws out there. You have a hand that's probably ahead, so you don't want to give a cheap card, and there's so much value to be had.
Gamela makes the call. There's now 394,000 in the pot. And that river card gives Gamela a straight.
Bad river for Eugene. That was such a bad river card for Eugene that I think Gamela's got to donk out here if he wants to get any value. Eugene could very easily check behind if Gamela checks.
Well, it looks like the Spaniard will bet the river. 300,000.
Now Gamela makes a huge bet, more than 3/4 of the pot. It's a polarizing bet, which typically means a monster or nothing, but Eugene's losing this so much now. Any big ace, any 10, king, queen, clubs, I think Eugene's perfectly capable of waiting for a better spot.
Well, he makes the call. You did say it was a polarizing bet, Joe, and I guess he's trying to catch a bluff.
Eugene's jet lag may have finally just caught up with him.
So Gamela wins the pot and adds another $500,000 to his stack. Well, this shows a tale of two players. They've won a similar number of pots pre-flop, but post-flop's a different story. Eugene not having a lot of success.
Evidenced by the fact that we've seen Eugene make two incorrect river decisions in as many hands.
On our outer table, Max Martinez is all in. And Isabel Baltazar has reshoved to freeze out Saar Wilf. Martinez has jacks, but Baltazar has queens.
Isabel Baltazar has been a one-woman wrecking crew, and she's poised to collect another scalp.
Top set on the flop. Martinez drawing to run a runner.
He's picked up some gut shot outs, but the 10 of clubs is no good.
3 outs. The Italian's done.
Arrivederci, Max. He was free-rolling anyway. Thierry shows a tattoo, 3-7 of hearts. Isabel Citra for the day, 307.
Spooky.
Who the heck has a tattoo of 3-7, by the way?
Maybe you got the tattoo done after she received her Citra.
Alors, je m'appelle Baltazar Isabel. Je suis nationalité française et d'origine portugaise. Et là, actuellement, je suis sur Saint-Germain-du-Puch. C'est un village qui se trouve entre Bordeaux et Saint-Émilion, dans le bon vin. Je suis restauratrice. J'ai un restaurant donc, dans la banlieue bordelaise. Et voilà, après, le poker, c'est juste une passion, un plaisir. Voilà, mais mon vrai métier, c'est le restauratrice. J'aime ce jeu. Je suis pas pro. Et je le vis pour comme un plaisir et pas comme comme il y en a certains qui c'est leur métier. Moi, c'est pas du tout mon métier. Non, j'ai pas du tout de stratégie. Mon plan, je vais continuer comme j'ai fait jusqu'à présent, qui m'a porté chance. Et j'espère aller le plus loin possible, c'est clair. Mais voilà, je prends que du plaisir.
Speaking of pleasure, I bet that Joker's pretty happy.
Let's return swiftly to our feature table.
Yes, swiftly.
Where action is on Dragan Kostic. He folds. Matty De Mulder has ace nine of diamonds.
Seems obvious enough.
He starts the hand with 971,000. And he is going to raise to 67,000. Schleich folds, Suzor folds. Tomeo Gamilla in the big blind has deuces.
You know, I didn't want to go along with your Gamilla the Poker Gorilla nickname, James, but his gum chewing is driving me bananas.
Ba-dum-tsh. Gamilla calls and we will see a flop. And that flop is all spades. Queen 9-3, second pair for Demolda.
Donk bet.
Gamilla leading for 100,000.
I don't like this donk bet at all. It's pretty much screaming, mess with me. Also, his hand has almost no equity. I guess it might be what he'd do if he flopped the flush, maybe?
Demolda makes a confused call. A fourth spade on the turn.
No one can really like that card.
Gamilla checks.
Looks like Matthias has a pretty good read of where his hand is at.
He bets 153,000.
Well, Gamilla has even less equity now than before when I said he had no equity. Yet he does not look like he wants to give up on this hand.
He shoves!
Make no mistake, well, this is crazy and that's no limit, baby, and all that. This is a bona fide punt attempt.
And Matthias frustratingly folds and Gamilla shows the bluff.
Wow.
Why are you doing such random stuff against me, man? What the hell?
That was quite random. I'm also not sure about the show. If I were him, I would not want these guys knowing I'm capable of a move like that. Though if his intent was to tilt Matthias, mission accomplished.
Demolda now down to 651,000. While Gamilla has doubled his stack over the course of today. It's the Barcelona leg of the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour. Before the break, Tomeo Gamilla bluffed Matty Demolda out of a pot and had the audacity to show the bluff. And he's continued to dominate this TV table.
I call.
He knocked out Hungary's Martin Zuzor, Jack King cracking ace-10. Now just 10 players remain, split over two tables.
As James mentioned, Spaniard Tomeo Gamilla has been running over the players of this table like a bull from Pamplona.
Blinds are up to 20 and 40,000 with an ante of 5,000. Action is on Tomeo Gamilla.
I raise.
Familiar story. King 7 suited under the gun. And he will make it 85,000. Dragan Kostic has ace-jack on the button.
I gotta tell you, with how loco Gamilla's been playing, I'm 3-betting the pantalones off him with a hand like ace-jack.
He just calls. Ace-10 in the small blind, and Demolda is moving all in.
You can totally see why Matthias would make this move.
Correct.
Gamilla should be laying down any second now.
What?
I am not a fan of this, but I guess if you're going to call, you might as well isolate.
I have good cap.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Even though it's the best hand this time, this would normally be a pretty easy fold.
No, Olin, I'm call.
Yeah, no duh.
We'll need some more of that run good.
Well, your brother looks busy right now, so I wouldn't expect him to bring you any luck.
Kostic folds.
Have a bet?
Ha!
Oh, no king, please.
Matthias is ahead, but as you can see, it's not by a large margin. Gamilla's got two live cards, and they're suited, so there's a lot that can go wrong here for Matthias.
Kostic revealing that he folded ace-jack, which had Demolda dominated.
10-10 deuce.
Well, there's a deuce, but no tens.
Things are looking much better for Matty. No real draws on that flop.
Ace of clubs.
Ace of clubs would have Gamilla drawing dead.
The turn is the deuce of diamonds.
Pairing the board is good for Matthias.
Gamilla drawing to a king or a seven on the river. And he hits a king!
Brutal.
That is a sick river card. But let's not forget that Matthias de Mulder got to this stage thanks to some sick outdraws. This is kind of a taste of his own medicine.
Ah, that's good.
When I go all in, it's better for you.
Yeah, I know.
Sure. Nah, he's feeling guilty.
De Mulder, 10th place finisher here at EPT Barcelona for 50,000 euros. That's his best tournament cash to date. Gamilla now sitting on 6.2 million.
Hey, Matthias, I know you're bummed, but we just got word from Noah Boken, and he says he's proud of you.
It's time for a redraw. We're down to one table of nine.
It has been a great run. Finishing 10th, I mean, up front you would, of course, immediately sign for it. But yeah, once you get this far, and the way I busted was also kind of nasty. I was able to squeeze off ace 10 and got called by king 7, and it was still 1.3 million pot, would have been completely back into the game. Board ran out, 6-4 deuce, turn deuce, river king. That king went through flesh and bone. Wow. I was stunned, but yeah, that's the nature of the game. There's nothing you can do about it. Like I said, it was a great run. I'm happy with the result, and on to the next one.
You can see right here where Matthias throws up a little in his mouth. Wow, and look at that. His twin brother is apparently going to stick around and hang out with that girl.
Let's take a look at how our final nine stack up. Tomeo Gumilla has a commanding lead right now. The player in immediate danger is Jose Esteban, nursing a stack of 17 big blinds.
All right, James, well, look, the gang's all here. The final nine.
The final table bubble. Isabel Baltazar will be first to speak. King 4 suited. She'll fold. As will Dragan Kostic. Raul Mestre passes. There's Esteban, the short stack. A6 of diamonds.
Not so hot nine-handed.
Tomeo Gumilla. 10-7 off.
This guy just won't quit. I guess if I were him, I wouldn't either.
Makes it 85,000. He's in late position. Saar Wilf folds. Martin Schleich passes from the button. Juan Corneo lets the small blind go. Eugene Kachalov has a suited queen.
There's one guy at the table who's been paying attention to what Gamilla's been up to. It's Eugene.
Kachalov making the call.
Eugene likely doesn't want to play a huge pot with this hand out of position, but I'm certain he's got a plan.
The flop is king, queen, three. Kachalov was ahead pre-flop, now he's way ahead.
95.
Gumilla betting 95,000 after Eugene checked to him.
That queen should really be all Eugene needs to station him the whole way. The problem is that Eugene doesn't really have a huge stack to be messing around.
Makes the call.
Oh, and look, Isabel's given her permission to the dealer to bring in the bet.
The turn card is the ace of hearts.
Neither player's really going to like that card.
It goes check, check. And the river is the nine of hearts.
Boy, this board really isn't doing Eugene any favors.
He checks. And Gamilla shoves.
This man is insane. Now, I was going to say that I was pretty sure Eugene was going to look him up here no matter what, but I'm glad I didn't. Based on Gamilla's recent history, it's hard to think he'd be bluffing again. But on a board like this, I think his value range is pretty narrow. Mostly flushes, I would say. So this bet is callable. Unfortunately, it's for Eugene's tournament life, and calling for your tournament with third pair no kicker isn't exactly a winning play overall. You can tell Eugene really wants to make this call.
We're so close to the final table now. He looks tortured.
Tortured by that gum chewing.
Eugene lets it go.
Oh no, he's gonna show again.
That's what he does. So Kachalov down to 850,000. The second shortest stack contrasts with the fortunes of Tomeo Gamilla.
Quite the crowd is forming by the feature table, maybe here to root on the five Spanish players, or maybe because it's the only air-conditioned building in the entire city.
Blinds up to 25.50, the 5K ante. Eugene lets the A7 go under the gun.
Yuck.
Isabel Baltazar will pass, as will Dragan Kostic. El Mestre folds. Jose Esteban has ace 10. He's in late position, and he moves all in. 650,000.
No reshove from Gamilla with queen 10.
Martin Schleich wants a count. He's sitting in the small blind with ace jack of clubs.
Martin folded ace queen suited to a 3-bet shove for less than this earlier today.
I'm all in.
He reshoves, and Corneo folds.
Martin's got Jose dominated.
The final table is in sight for 8 players. Jose Esteban on the verge of elimination. Although we have seen some bad beats here today.
Unfortunately, I think Gamilla's been gobbling up all the Spanish run good like a plate of paella.
The flop. It's 5-3-5.
Schleich's ace-jack holding.
Esteban looking for a 10.
James, we are one card away from the final table.
A 9 or a 3 for a split, a 10 for the win. Any other card, we're down to 8. It's a king. Jose Esteban is the final table bubble boy.
No way, Jose.
50,000 euros for ninth place. The 8 remaining players will come back for day 5 of this tournament. They'll come back for the final table.
The Squirmin German, the Lesson Demure Restaurateur, Gamilla the Poker Gorilla, and Eugene the final table machine.
Oh, Eugene's going to have his work cut out. He's down to just 14 big blinds. At the other end of the spectrum, Tomeo Gamilla has a commanding chip lead with a 140 big blind stack. It's all to play for at the EPT 8 Barcelona final table. 4 of the finalists will be railed by the home crowd, hungry to see the first ever Spanish champion.
I'm sure a Spanish player win the EPT.
But Triple Crown contender Eugene Kachalov isn't ready to just roll over.
He left me in the same spot yesterday. A little different now.
The pressure is on. Who will fall first? Who will come out on top? One table, one title, one shot at glory.